Just recently, I visited Karla Caves, the largest of the Karla-Bhaje-Bedse caves complex, situated near Lonavala, and it is merely 60 to 75 kilometers away from Pune. These ancient Indian Buddhist caves were carved from 2nd century BC and its development continued till 5th century AD. Karla Caves were called Valukura during that time, and since this place was an ancient trade route from Arabian Sea to Deccan Plateau, these caves might have held much significance in the past. These caves are now protected monuments under the Archeological Survey of India. A brief introductory text is available if you are inclined to know details. Just pause the video and you can read it. At the entrance, there is a tall pillar and its top is adorned with sculptures of lions facing four sides. Another pillar is destroyed completely. The left and the right side has sculptures of elephants and Buddha along with sculptures of couples. These are a bit bold poses and I feel beauty of women bodies were admired or rather celebrated. However, I always believed Buddhism advocated monastic livelihood and was for meditating monks who delved deep in search of keys of eternal happiness. The outer walls have beautifully carved repetitive designer frames which look like windows to me. The carvings are extraordinarily fine and marvelous. There are inscriptions written in Brahmi and Greek on walls and pillars. I could also spot swastik marked on small portion. Swastik in Indian culture is an auspicious symbol, and spotting it on such an old structure means the symbol and its meaning was derived from Vedic or Sanatan Dharma. As I entered the Chaitigruha or prayer hall, I realized that it is bigger than that of Bhaje or Bedse and has horseshoe styled wooden architecture at the ceiling. The stupa has a wooden roof covering its top. Each of the pillars inside the hall has beautiful sculptures on top and a few pillars have something written on them. The scripts are Brahmi and Old Greek. There is also one pillar that has Devanagari script, which I believe to be carved much later. One pillar has a stupa, replica of pillar from Sarnath, which is my assumption, and another structure which I do not know about. Just outside the prayer hall, there are a few rooms that might have been used by monks for resting. A little farther, there are more small rooms on ground and first floor connected by narrow stairs. An entire tour to the caves takes about 15-20 minutes. You may like to spend some more time here if there is no crowd. I suggest you to visit the caves during monsoon when it is all lush green and the mesmerizing view at the top will make you spend more time. Maybe meditate like an old and wise Buddhist monk. Do let me know how you feel about visiting this place. Subscribe my YouTube channel iroguehermit. Stay updated on Twitter @i_roguehermit. Read my blogs on iroguehermit.blogspot.in and follow my Facebook page iroguehermit.